The moment we've all been waiting for. Oh, really? Oh. Damn. Well, we lost another key. It's opening. It's a portal to... where? And what's that? It has zeros on it? Oh, things alive, okay. Steam operated. Ooh, hypnotizing. Oops. Bye. Oh, he saw me go up in that beam. Hiveswap. The end? Nope. Not just yet. Oh, we're in a new place? On the other side of this portal. Oh, what hit me? Someone get the license plate number of that truck? I'm in some kind of... industrial, like, garage? Like, warehouse? Storage house? It looks kind of like the thing from the your attic that brought you here. The force field is a pretty striking point of contrast, though. Maybe you can use this thing to get home somehow? Please? They look like we traded places. We went here and someone else came from here to our attic? I think? That didn't exactly hurt, but it was kind of tingly. You don't think you'd be able to reach the portal with that force field on. Byers regards the shimmering portal with the same dazed cluelessness with which he regards everything else in existence. He is endearingly democratic in his stupidity. You give it a little dusting with your spice mix. In a strange way, it makes you feel slightly better about everything. Huh. The thing doesn't seem to need any additional power. Look at its sizzle. That's the biggest slammer you've ever seen. This thing ain't no treat, and you don't think you'd be petting it anytime soon. The portal is responding to your tap dancing. The force field dissipates, and you return home immediately. Lie. Wait, no it doesn't. You were just caught up in one of your hallucinatory fugues of dance optimism. Imagine how that worked, though. I'd be like, wait, I didn't look around this area. You guess this thing is protected by one of those rare force fields that doesn't power down just because someone did ballet near it. Okay, what's this? A busted up robot? It seems like something pretty intense went down here just before you arrived. Keep Byers away from that thing. It could still be dangerous. The spices failed to make the robot even remotely functional or appetizing. It seemed to be busted up beyond what some new batteries could fix. At least in death, it's immune to abuse from your stupid pogs. Yeah, not my pogs. Something tells you that this busted heap of scrap isn't treat compliant. The busted parts rattle around just a little, so mildly you can barely see it. But it happened. It happened, man. You're just not motivated to dance on this robot's grave. Oh, I thought that was up. Ew, look at... what's a slime? You pick up a hand-drawn, scribbled-on diagram of the portal, showing how the pieces fit together. Ugh. We got a diagram? Where? Oh, this. A faded copy of a hand-drawn diagram labeling the parts of the mysterious portal and showing how they fit together. This diagram does not seem to incorporate pigeons, neither as a vital component nor as a recurring visual motif. You sprinkle some magic spice mix on the diagram in the hopes that it will reveal some kind of spice-activated invisible ink. Your hopes are dashed. Get it? According to this diagram, your batteries could be used to... okay, time to come clean. You have no idea how to read this stupid thing. This diagram is way too visually busy. As such, it would be a pretty lousy slamming grid for your pog battles or pogroms. Yes, that's it. All you have to do is jam some pet treats in between the gears and it'll stop working. Of course, there's the force field to deal with. And you aren't sure how you get the thing open even if the force field was down. And you've already been launched who knows how far through the inky blackness of space, marooned in some weird techno basement without any idea how to get back home. And you're still so very, very hungry. And the kids at school are mean. And sometimes you feel like you should make more of an effort to relate to Jude, but he's so stupidly self-assured, and you aren't sometimes. It's hard to be a nice big sister when you resent him for that. But as long as you're on the subject, your babysitter's drinking is maybe getting out of hand. But once you get that stuff taken care of, pet treats to the rescue. Do I want to eat the pet treats? Same line as ever. Looks like somebody already shook this to pieces. The steps seem a little too complicated for you to follow, at least without some dedicated study first. Additionally, it's some kind of detailed mechanical schematic and not dance steps, so that's going to be a bit of a hurdle. Diagram on robot. The robot seems to be cut from an entirely different cloth than whatever is depicted in the diagram. To put it in more accessible terms, it looks like this one was made by Sega and the other was made by Nintendo. Ooh, burn. Sega does what Nintendo don't. Wow, this does indeed seem to be a diagram of this portal. For all the good that does you, which is currently not at all. Alright. There's a gun there. Oh, what about this thing? Some kind of weird electric bug? It seems to be trying to communicate. Maybe we should pick it up for a closer look. You pause. Maybe you could try figuring out what this thing is before you start shoving pogs into it, or tap dancing on it, or whatever other wild idea you were just entertaining. Same, right? Alright, let's just pick it up, because it's not going to say anything. Well, let's try this. Yeah, alright, we're picking it up. You pick up the flashing board, words blink on the screen in an unfamiliar alphabet. For some reason, you can understand it anyway. Oh. Hello, is someone there? Is this a chat room? Who's talking? If a moderator is present, I require some assistance, please. Tetrarch. Huh? There was a huge explosion. XO. Were you harmed? Thanks for asking, although I didn't see any explosion. Well, I guess this is us then. Well, maybe I did, sorta. The roof of your hive is totally jacked. If you say so. Wait, you can see my roof? Who are you? What do you mean, my hive? Oh. Oh no. I'm so sorry, I forgot the code again. I'm really trying, I swear. It's just because I was so worried about you I wasn't thinking, and it'll never happen again, I promise. What's going on? Okay. Whoever this is chatting, do he or she or they think we're someone else? Nothing. All that matters is that you're okay. You are okay, right? Where am I? Okay, yeah, I know this one for sure. You're in your basement, right? I mean, you're not there. You're somewhere else. Oops, did I say the wrong thing? What do you want me to tell you? Where do you want me to tell you you are? Who are you? I'm Zephyros. Oh no. That was a test, wasn't it? Okay, I know I just said it would never happen again, and I mean that starting from now. No exceptions to the code. I'm actually not Zephyros. I'm absolutely not Zephyros. Right. X? Sorry. Why are you apologizing? It never hurts to be sorry. So, Zephyros, I'm getting that I'm in a basement somewhere, but why? But you think we shouldn't say that? Yeah, that's exactly right. I got it right. Didn't I? If you say so. I don't suppose you know what the deal is with this huge machine with the snakes on it? It's like sort of like the one in my attic. Except the one in my attic wasn't so space-age and it didn't have a weird force field bubble. Attic? You know, down the hall, up the stairs? The highest room in the house? Oh, duh. War code. Sorry. Yeah, the secret weapon. I'm sorry about that. Tetrarchdemic. Secret weapon? Tetrarchdemic? Sorry, I know I keep messing up. I'm doing my best. What is Tetrarchdemic? Your name? I mean, not your name. My name isn't Tetrarchdemic. Of course not. Never know who might be reading. Oh geez, what was your code name again? My name is Joey. Right, I knew that. This was all my fault, I'm sorry. I had no idea things would go so wrong. Wait, what? I was going to ask you first, but then I thought maybe it was a quiz and that if I had to stop to ask you, I would fail it. So I just put the battery in the weapon, like you said. Wait, what are you talking about? I thought you left that weird paper out on the crate as instructions. Weird paper? Not weird, great. The plan is great, Joey. The heiress will never expect it. I mean, I'm still not sure I get what it is exactly, but still. Just proud to be entrusted with such an important duty. Hey, let me get back to you. So now I got a thing to... Hey, I found the paper you were asking about. So what do I do with it? So we've got another, like, a walkie-talkie type thing. Well, it's a chat thing. Well, okay, give me a minute. I know this. Ugh, I'm really sorry. I don't think you'd be quizzing me... I didn't think you'd be quizzing me right after what happened. I swear I'll prepare better next time. It's okay. Wow, really? Yes, really. It's not a quiz. I have no idea what any of this means. Oh, jeez. Is it a test? No. I seriously have no idea what's going on here. I've never seen this thing before. What is it telling me? I'm doing my best, but I don't know what you want me to do. Please tell me what you want me to say. So this paper seems like some kind of schematic for the portal I just came through. It looks kind of familiar, not just the portal, but the paper itself. I don't know how that would be possible, though. Anyway, is that right? This is a diagram for the snake machine? Well, if I remember that right, that thing is a guide to the weapon. The weapon? You mean this snake portal? Oops, the code. Okay, yes, the portal. Can I unlock the snake machine with this? Is that what I should do? Unlock the snake machine? Oh, the serpent security program for your hive's power hexagrid. Yes, if that's what you want, Tetrarch. You can always do whatever you want. Wow. Well, that thing you said, will that help me get out of here? Exactly. Just put all the X fingers on the back of your tablet until the control panel uplink executes. X? 10? Oh no. I'm in trouble. I did exactly what I'm not supposed to. That was a test. That was an test, and I blew it, of course. You remember, and I definitely shouldn't have said any of that. I'm so sorry it's hard to keep up with these espionage rules sometimes. Okay, I'll just go check that out. I'm so sorry, Tetrarch. I'm just gonna leave you to whatever it is that you do. Okay, good enough. Okay, so... what else is in here? A futuristic-looking door in a gloomy, futuristic-looking, bunker-like place. Maybe all the answers are through here? You have no idea how to open this thing. You don't even see a handle. But if you had to guess, it looks like it's automatic. But the power seems to be off in here. You think. It's kind of hard to tell. You have no idea. Same. Okay, that saves me having to do any of this. Okay. If you hid inside this crate, you'd think you'd be nervous that it was going to somehow suddenly close up around you and you'd be left screaming in the dark in a slimy box somewhere impossibly far from your home. So you didn't think you'd be hiding in the crate just now. Yeah, it's all coming together. The portal depicted on this sketchy diagram was in the crate. And then, okay, that's all you got so far. It looks too much like a big version of his cage back home. If you sent him inside, you'd have a hard time getting him to come out. To be perfectly frank, it doesn't look all that much like his cage, but he is kind of a moron, so you decide to play it safe. To spice the crate to the zest of your abilities... You spice the crate to the zest of your abilities. It is now a spicy crate. To save time, however, you will still refer to it as a crate, if you have reason to refer to it. The crate seems to be fulfilling its functions as a crate without the alliterative assistant of your clumsy copper tops. When it comes to pogs, it's hard for you to muster any crate enthusiasm. Wow, pet treats? An enormous crate? All that's missing is some kind of monstrous behemoth to eat the treats and live in the crate and maybe eat you too, and oh man, you're freaking yourself out again. The slimy, goo-slick surface of the crate's wooden interior would serve as a lousy stage for the ribald staccato of your fancy footwork, and it's also pretty dark in there, so you'll pass. You could perform a quick bit of ballet in the crate, like it was some kind of oversized creepy music box, but there's already an oversized creepy music box in the room, and you don't want to gild the oversized creepy lily. There is? Okay, that's it for this side of the room, I think, then. What's this? It's another gun. This one looks a lot more sophisticated and deadly than your pa's weaponry, which you left back in the attic. You think you leave this one where it is, too. You don't think so. It looks kind of weird, and it's still plainly a gun. This futuristic gun kind of looks like the tongues in the mouths of the creepy snakeheads. You aren't wild about any part of that sentence. His delicate little wingalings are too clumsy to work the trigger. You assume you won't be testing that particular hypothesis. If you had some kind of meat, you could maybe spice it up and cook it with a sci-fi ray gun. Except you don't like guns, you don't have any meat, and you're not a lunatic who dreams of eating lasered meat in some weird dark room. If the ray gun were out of rays, maybe you could power it with this battery, except you have no interest in doing that because you don't use guns. You don't use them. If your pa were here, it'd probably be all about this stupid thing, but you're not. You're Joey Claire, dang it, not Joey Claire's crappy pa. Oh yeah, you can flip the pog way up in the air and shoot a hole in it, demonstrating your crackerjack marksmanship and your distaste for cardboard garbage discs. You could do both of those things at once, if you didn't hate guns. You could, jam the pet treats down the barrel of this ray gun, you guess. Okay, you got nothing on this one. Tap dancing on a ray gun sounds like a really surreal way to die. Are you graceful enough to dodge lasers? You hope you won't have to find out. Okay, let's look in the control panel. There's another door that's moving. Some kind of forklifty type of thing. And I think that's it. It's a futuristic forklift. It's probably what moved that giant crate here. Alright, I'll mess with it. Because that's what I do. Nothing happened. You can just imagine Byers driving a forklift with a little, hat, you guess, and... well, his wings wouldn't reach the steering knob, and plus the forklift isn't working, and... Okay, you guess you can't imagine it. Putting sugar in the gas tank probably isn't going to help. Your forklift does seem like it may need power, but you can't find a place to put your crummy little batteries. Nice try, doofus, you mutter to yourself under your breath, And now for the first time, your spirit nearly broken, you somehow struggle on. Either this thing doesn't run on pogs, or its pog-based fuel tank is not currently empty, and the problem is something else. Mush, noble forklift. Yah! Yah! Treats! Go! Run for the treats! Go! Mush, you indolent beast! Hath thee no hunger? You give the forklift some accelerando, and it accelerando don't want no part of it. You try to engage the forklift in a little pas de deux, but it remains in first position. You don't know how to drive this thing. It doesn't seem to be on anyway. You can hear awful slams and growls coming from the other side of this door. You aren't going to try to open it. You consider sliding the diagram under the door, but it seems like it might be important, and the frenzied rip snorps and stomp kicks of the crazed beast on the other side gives you pause. You mean pause. Byers is plainly freaked out by the sounds coming from the other side of this door. You can't blame him, because you are too. Ah, what a treat. Creepy basement door with some spice on it. Just like Mama used to make. Whoops. Now you're sad and scared. You stick the battery into the side of the shed door and pretend that it's a doorknob. You turn it. It doesn't work. You guess you could have tried powering the mysterious door somehow with your battery, but you have no idea how to do this, to do that, and it probably wouldn't work, so you decided to fail in a more whimsical manner. You slide one of the pogs under the door in an attempt to placate the ferocious beast you can hear on the other side of the door. If anything, this seems to make it more angry. You try to force a pet treat under the shed door to placate whatever wild monster is kicking up a ruckus in there, but it just won't fit. You kind of feel bad for the monster, but also pretty relieved it's in there instead of out here. So a cog will fit, but not a pet treat? You fire off a back Irish into a flea hop, but the door remains closed. Your ballet doesn't seem to have opened the door, which is really for the best, since it doesn't seem to have calmed down the angry monster on the other side either. You place all 10 of your fingers on the back of the tablet and approach the control panel. Hey, some kind of password entry program appears on the screen. Monstre. What's this? Snake? Do I move with the arrow keys or with WASD? Or neither? This diagram doesn't give you any insight into how the control panel functions, which is kind of weird, because you definitely get a serpent vibe from the control panel, which is kind of weird, period. Byers lacks the sterling mental acuity necessary to use this control panel. He also falls asleep if you put a napkin on his head, because he thinks it's nighttime, so this comes as something less than a shock. You sprinkle a bunch of spice mix down all the control panel's most inviting crevices. It is now running a 0.0006% less efficiently. You don't see a removable panel to add the batteries. Wait, oh gosh, there it... No, wait, no. No panel. You try to jauntily flip a pog into the coin slot of the control panel like it's an old-timey jukebox, but there's no coin slot, and also you accidentally flip the pog directly into your own eye, so you don't think you'll be including this moment in your hero memoirs. Ah, if only the humble control panel could be a pet. If only. If only. Ah, little panel, simple and kind, floating through life like a baby miracle. You would shower it in pet treats, if that were possible, but it isn't, so that dream is dead. Jeez. You dance your heart out. The control kiosk is unaffected. Everyone's a critic. A cold, metal critic in a dark, anonymous basement. Everyone who doesn't live like you're dancing is that. No response. What a snobby little Philistine this control panel turned out to be. Let's give it another shot. The program fires up or something. How do I move? Do I click places? Do I... Okay, well, let's give that another shot. The program boots up again. Wait, it's just WASD, doesn't it? Oh, I'm controlling the thing. Wait. I thought I was controlling that little thing. I am controlling the snake, actually. I can't move it, but... Let me see something. No, I don't want to do that. I don't think my thing is working right now. Okay, hold on one second, guys. Okay, we're back. So I think I can use the arrow keys now. This thing was like plugged in, but like not, I don't know. I use a tactical board. Okay, so I have it plugged into the USB port, one of the USB ports in the back of the computer, and those randomly, I don't know, deactivate it. So I had to unplug it and plug it back in, and now it's working. Am I supposed to get this thing? Guess so. I used to be really good at this on my Nokia phone. Back in the 90s. I think I had it back in the 90s. Got it? Now what happens? Oh, that started up? Oh! Okay. Oh. Hello? Hello, majestic beast. Please don't kill me. That was funny. Okay, hello. Hey, Xerox, are you there? I don't know how I feel about the codename Xerox. It's pretty close to Zephyros, don't you think? I mean, imagine I called you Damn It. Not that I would ever do that. Sorry. Okay, I don't really know what to say to any of that. Sorry. It's fine, stop apologizing. It's actually really annoying when you do that all the time, FYI. Oh, sorry. Ugh, forget about it. I wanted to ask you about the security console. I played the game on it, but all that happened was a forklift drove straight into the force field and exploded. Whoa, your forklift exploded? Yeah, it's not mine, though. Is it yours? I'm sorry I wrecked it. No, of course not. Or, I mean, do you want me to take it? Because it's broken? I wouldn't mind, I mean, whatever. Up to you. Alright, and then a weird monster menaced me into this other room and there's only one door? This is kind of a bad situation. Weird monster? Yeah, that, deer cat thing. Deer cat thing? Are you having a fight with your Lucis? Not that it's any of your business. Lucis? Is that what you call that thing? I barely got away with my life. Wait a minute. Are you actually not Tetrodemic? No, I'm Joey. Joey Claire. I don't know what's going on. There's a bunch of big computers and boxes, and I don't know where I am or who you are, but you kept acting like you knew what was going on. Well, what are you doing with the Tetrox tablet? You mean this Trapper Keeper laptop? I found it on the floor. Oh no. Is Tetrodemic there? Maybe I could talk to him instead. Please. Please give the tablet to Tetrodemic, please. I don't know who Tetrodemic is. I don't know who you are. Could you look for him, please? Okay, yeah, I'll just root around in the room that's filled with guns. Okay, then. Okay, thanks, actually. Some sort of highly advanced communications device. Oh, I can't use it? Okay. Stuff. Okay. Stuff. This door is all that stands between you and that rampaging deer monster. No way. If you wanted to get killed by a weird monster in the basement, you would have stayed at home. Yeah, something about the smooth power of these twin doors reminds you a little of the snake's reed portal in the other room. In both sleek sets, you see the paradoxical union of immutability and coil power, immovable and yet ready to move with no warning at all. Byra seems to sense the ferocious deer-cat monster looking just on the other side of this door. You could hit that deer-cat with a snoot full of spice mix to scare it off, but after what happened to the monster in your kitchen, you're worried that might actually constitute lethal force. When you play that snakes game, you seem to have restored power to this whole place, so there's no reason for you to go around jabbing your E-cell batteries at everything. Not that you'd let that stop you, of course. The doors are sealed together far too tightly for you to even entertain the goofy idea of slipping a pog between them. So you don't entertain the idea, and the idea really doesn't entertain you. You don't want to give that rampaging beast any further incentive to burst this door down and tear you to shreds, or bust this door down, rather, which obviously is what it was intending to do, right? Yeah. The doors weather your staccato fury with nary a tremble. You give the huge steel doors a stirring performance, but the curtains refuse to part, which is a good thing, considering there's a slavering monster on the other side. Well, slavering might be a stretch, but look, you're pretty sure you saw it slaver. You're like 60% confident there was some conspicuous slavering. Okay. Okay, we got stuff. Lots of boxes and stuff. That's a lot of boxes, crates, miscellaneous containers, etc. Pretty mundane stuff, in your humble opinion. Not your first box stack rodeo. I want to talk again. Let me do all this first. The diagram doesn't call for boxes or bullets. Maybe it uses kids for ammunition? Does the stack of bullet-filled boxes remind Byers of your attic? Does Byers miss his home? Is Byers freaked out from being shot across space? Maybe you could grow some herbs and such yourself one day, but this is the wrong kind of box garden. What if you put the batteries in the box, and then when someone was frantically reaching into them, the boxes, for ammo, someone pulled them, the batteries out instead. What a riot that would be, you guess. You could just dump these little trash discs here, but at this point you feel like holding on to as much of home as you can. Just a specific point, though. You're liable to start hucking these things in the trash any minute now. You really thought that would work. Although maybe it's better that it didn't, considering these boxes are probably full of bullets and missiles and stuff. Wouldn't the box step be more appropriate? Did you find him? No. Oh no. I don't know what to do. What should I do? Oh my god. Why on earth are you asking me? What's Earth? What? Oh. My. God. Jude, is that you? Is this another one of your stupid practical jokes? This isn't funny. No, I'm Zephyros. Okay, Zephyros, tell me what is going on. I don't really know. Actually, I'm kind of upset because you're yelling and that makes it harder to think. I know I'm not very smart or good at anything, but I really am trying my best. I'm sorry. I can't believe this. I'm the one who just got shot through space into an alien nightmare horror house, and you expect me to make you feel better? Look, we all have self-esteem issues, but there's a time and a place for pathetic groveling, and it is not why I'm trying to not be devoured by alien monsters. Wait, you're an alien? I'm 2 seconds away from throwing this disgusting joke machine into one of several of the massive piles of armed and dangerous garbage behind me. Wait, no, don't. This is so exciting, I've never met an alien before. I'm like seriously losing it. Most trolls never meet aliens until they go off-planet to conquer them. What? Oh, okay, but like, you could be messing with me. Are you messing with me? The Tetrarch says I have to stop being so trusting. Oh, I know. Say something only an alien would say. I'm a nightmare squid god. You are? Yep, with two huge mouths and a jillion eyes. Ugh, sorry. This is all a little nuts, and the deer cat maybe got me a little rattled. So you're not an alien? No, I am? I mean, if this seriously isn't Earth? Which, between the snake machine and the deer cat and the sci-fi technology, I'm willing to believe. Plus, there was some other monsters earlier, so I am having that kind of day. Monsters? Yeah, I managed to get past them, barely. Whoa, you're so cool. You're like on a real adventure. Wait, what color is your blood? What kind of question is that? I'm so sorry, I didn't mean to be disrespectful. I just wanted to be sure I knew before I made a mess of things. Okay. It's red? Really? Me too. Awesome. We could even be friends. This is so cool. Hey, maybe I could even help you. How? The Tetrarch Lucis knows me. He'll calm down if I can get over there. By Lucis, you mean the deer cat monster? Yes. That's wonderful, thank you. Yeah. Except, I don't know. I'm still worried this might be a big test. A test? I don't follow, sorry. Boy, is it getting kind of frustrating having to say that over and over. The Tetrarch is always testing me. If this is the final Zarn of secrecy stuff, or Zam? I think it's Zam. If this is the final Zam of secrecy stuff, and I blow it, he's going to be really disappointed. Oh, I know. If you can prove you're an alien, I'll come over and help you out. Do you want me to say more alien things? No, I mean, I have no way to verify if those are true or not. Oh, send me a picture of you. I don't have any photos with me, and anyway, how could I get it to you? I'm trapped in here by that monster. Aren't you using the Tetrarch's tablet? Take the pics with that and transmit it over. Pictures, transmit. Okay, that's kind of a weird ask, Xerox. But I'll give it a shot. Here goes. Selfie time? Oh my god, a selfie in the 90s.